Hello people, welcome to this video. Let's see quickly and easily all you need to know to start using SketchUp Pro 2016. If you have problems with the accent in this video, enable our closed captions clicking on the CC icon in the bottom right corner. SketchUp Pro is a software used for architectural projects, CAD designs, and 3D-like representations with the simplest user-friendly interface. When you open SketchUp, a welcome window appears, used to properly start with a new project. This is composed by three different sections. Learn is used to get tips and official tutorials about SketchUp, very useful especially if you are just starting. License checks and shows your personal license, whereas template is used to choose how to start with your new project, choosing the general environment and the measurement unit to be used. For example, for 3D projects, you can choose simple templates, architectural designs or urban plannings. And for 2D projects, you can choose a construction template instead. Let's take, for example, the simple template. Just click on it to select it, and then click on Start using SketchUp below. A new blank project will appear in front of you. Its workspace is quite simple. On top, you have all the main important tools used to build and preview your work. On the right, several useful panels that list all object components and information. And the rest of the workspace is dedicated to a full preview of your project. Often check out the instructor panel that suggests useful tips while you work, especially for your first projects. In case you close any of these panels by mistake, you can open them again going to the Window tab above. In case of 3D templates like this one, there is represented a 2D human figure on the project that represents the average height of a person. This can help you in having an idea of the dimensions of your future objects. You also have the three Cartesian axes representing the main directions. The x-axis in red representing the horizontal position respect to the origin. The y-axis in green representing the vertical position. And the z-axis in blue that indicates the height respect to ground, here colored in green. Let's see now how to draw in 2D. To draw simple lines, you can use the third button from the left. Line is used to draw lines and edges. Just fix its main points on your workspace, on and on. While you draw, SketchUp will show a preview of what you are going to draw. In particular, the segment will be colored every time you follow one of the main directions. For example, if the line turns in red, it means that you are going to draw it parallel to the x-axis. With this tool, you will go on drawing consecutive lines. To stop drawing, use Escape key or simply close the path. In this case, you will create a polygon filled inside. If you have a mistake, use Ctrl and Z to undo your latest action or use the eraser to remove objects created on your project. Just click and drag. If you want to draw freehand, just click on the black arrow next to line and choose freehand. You can use this arrow to show more tools inside the same button. Through the fourth icon, you can draw arcs in different ways. Use the fifth button to draw rectangles, circles, and polygons. Being closed paths, also these are filled when you create them. Always check the instructor panel if you need more help at drawing these. Let's now see how to draw and create 3D objects. For example, you can build 3D objects completely manually. The feeling that this created when you close paths is the same one used for the faces of a 3D object. So, to create a 3D object, it is sufficient to create all the necessary faces to complete it. Just mind that, once finished, all faces created will remain independent, and these can be hard to manage in the future. To group all them together, simply enable the Select tool and select all faces composing the 3D object. You can click and drag to create a selection area in order to select all objects that fall inside it. Then just right-click and go to Make Group. A second way is to use the Push-Pull tool. If you already have a 2D base and you just need to pull it up, enable the Push-Pull tool and click and drag to add extrusion perpendicular to such base. This tool may not work on faces that belong to existing groups. In these cases, select the group, right-click and go to Explode. Then, just apply the Push-Pull tool normally. If you need to check your project better, you can zoom in and out using your mouse wheel or use the Orbit tool and click and drag to have a complete 3D check on your work. SketchUp helps you with snappings to some key points in order to make drawings more easy. Below your pointer, different nodes may appear case by case. Endpoints, midpoints, and centers are usually represented through small circles, points along a path through squares, and points along a face or surface through rhombuses. Also, dashed guidelines can help you draw in parallel or perpendicular to other nodes. Let's see how to edit existing objects. Before editing, it is important to select all objects you want to edit altogether. If you don't do so, you may edit in a wrong way. The Move tool simply moves selected objects. Just click and drag. A dashed line indicates the path you are moving the object through. Check also its color. You will move parallel to an axis if this has its same color. The Rotate tool is used to rotate objects. Firstly, you need to fix the rotation point. The goniometer will be fixed and this will be adapted to the plane it finds. Then, fix a second point to define an axis and then define the angle of rotation to rotate. The Scale tool is used to scale and deform the objects selected. When you enable it, a yellow structure appears. Hover on each green cube to know what's the exact direction you are going to deform or scale the object. Then, just drag the cubes. Also, the Push-Pull tool can be used to add extrusion starting from the faces of existing 3D objects. Whenever you want to exit while using any of these tools, just use Escape key. The Offset tool creates a second object starting from an existing polygon or face with the same basic shape and keeping constant the distance from the border sides. If you need to cut, copy, and paste an object, Select it with the Select tool and use Ctrl and X, Ctrl and C and Ctrl and V respectively. Let's see how to fill up 2D and 3D objects. Basically, you can fill up any enclosed path that, by default, has a silver-like filling. On the right, you can use two panels to fill properly: Entity Info and Materials. Under Entity Info, you can click on the first rectangle to set a basic filling color. To use professional materials, you go to Materials, choosing from a wide list of folders below. To start filling up, click on the sample above and then on all the faces or polygons interested. If you click on Groups, you fill up all the single objects inside composing such group. SketchUp has also several tools to annotate inside your project that you can show right-clicking on top and going to Construction. Let's see, for example, how to add text. To add independent text, go to 3D Text. Check or uncheck on Extruded to choose between 3D and 2D text. Type inside, decide font style and distribution, and then click on Place to fix it on the project. This text will lay on the current plane it sees. The 2D or 3D text created is a complex object. SketchUp groups it all automatically to manage it easily. But if you want to personalize it, right-click on it and go to Edit Component to edit each single part. When you finish, right-click again and go to Close Component to group again. There are lots of more things you can do with SketchUp. If you want to go more in detail with all the features it has, check out our full guide available. Finally, let's see how to save your project. If you go to File and then to Save As, you will save your project as a .skp file, known as SketchUp Project or Model, that you can open and edit anytime you need, going to File and then to Open. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel for more about SketchUp Pro 2016.